Sean said that that the DEA claims that marijuana is harmful and has no medical use. And then Ethan said that that medical doesn't have a big impact in the DEA, and that it should stay as a Schedule I drug. And then Sean also says that people suffer from opioid abuse more than marijuana. And so my first claim is drugs considered less harmful than marijuana accounted for 70% of overdoses. By Duke London, a law and politics writer from marijuana.com, published on February 3rd, 2017. In 2013, opioids like the ones listed as less harmful than marijuana accounted for 70% of the overdose fatalities in the United States. The other 30% of lethal overdoses involved benzodiazepines like Xanax, which you can find on the CSA all the way down to Schedule 4, where the government believes drugs have a low potential for abuse and low risk of dependence. Xanax is a very abused drug, and people have easier access to that than marijuana, whereas marijuana doesn't have any huge impacts of being abused or causing overdoses and deaths. And that's significant because people have easy access to Xanax, whereas marijuana, people use it, but they don't have a huge harm, and it causes and it doesn't cause major damages. And then my second claim, from what Sean said, the state should decide if they want marijuana to be legal. That's by David Firestone, NBC managing editor of the New York Times, published on July 27th, 2014. The states are taking the lead because they're wary of locking up thousands of their own citizens for possessing a substance that has less potential for abuse and destructive behavior than alcohol. A decision about what kinds of substance to permit and under what conditions belongs in the purview of the states as alcohol is handled. There's a lot of illegal activity with marijuana, and so we lose a lot of tax revenue from that, and making it legal will, in states and in the federal level, will help give us more tax revenue, and it'll be up to the states to decide whether it's harmful to their people or not. Ethan states that many people will suffer. Many people suffer if it stays, and that teens that smoke lose up to 8 IQ points. Adults don't show any notable decline. Marijuana is only accessible if you are at the legal age in states like Colorado and in California. So making it legal will help prevent illegal use of marijuana and access to it. And then Ethan also says that states control substances such as alcohol and Sean says that the states control the substances, and like same as alcohol and tobacco, and then we shouldn't have restrictions on it, but it should be restrictions only put on by the state. But legalizing marijuana will uphold state rights. Alice Wallace, the cannabis staff, is now stand open for cross-examination.
Can you read to me what you said in your second point?
The states are taking the lead because they were blocking out thousands of their own citizens for possessing a substance that has less potential for abuse and destructive behavior than alcohol. The decision about what kinds of substance to permit and under what conditions belongs in the purview of the states as alcohol is handled.
In your third contention, you said that in Colorado, only people that are obtaining weed is the adults, yet we all know that kids obtain weed all the time. Do you agree with that fact that you said that it's only adults get weed?
No, but I believe that the states like that, it's they have it legal, and the parents decide whether they want their children to have access to marijuana or not.
In the first contention, you said that there is no overdose for marijuana?
Yeah.
Do you have any evidence on that?
I only have evidence that 70% of the overdose fatalities in the United States are caused from opioids.
But you don't have any for marijuana?
No.
Can you please reread to me your third contention quote?
Done?
Yeah.
You can say, okay, thank you.
Okay.